Okay then people, in this vid we're going to be having a look at little look at Big Dog. Okay, we have a slight technical problem. Yeah, I'm a little disappointed to be honest with you. That Variac up in front of the camera there, that one, I was using it the other night and well, this funny sound started coming out of it. And then well, a flipping bouquet that started coming out of it really started slinging up. And I just can't put my finger on the smell that was coming out of it. What I want to do in this vid is have that casing off. And somewhere around about the 140 volt mark. Around about there. That's where I had it. To around about there. And you can feel on there as the pickup track is a little bit lumpy. And yeah, something's not quite right in there. And I don't know whether the brush is stuck in the holder or what it is. But yeah, I was using that and the flipping bouquet that started coming out of it, it was really starting to, you know, it was slinging up something proper. Also, before that started happening, it must have been about, I suppose, about a week or two before that started happening. I was using it, again, rather late at night. I only had like a little fan heater on it, which, if you had a fan heater going full bore, it pulls about eight amps off the wall socket. But the thing is, I only had that around about 160. So, you probably look at about 5-6 amps. And, well, when I was using it, admittedly, it was in a darkened room. You know, because I had a fan heater on it. And, well, this is one of these things that I use in my bedroom anyway. So, you know, I was just getting undressed for the night and I thought to myself, I'll put the fan heater on. Turn it up on the Variac. Believe it or not, I do that. And while I was using it, somewhere around about down there, sort of around about sort of region, there's a mighty great pop that come out of it. A nice big flash that come out of it. And I've got a feeling basically the, if it is what I think it is, that burning smell in there, it's probably little pieces of carbon brush gotten in between the pickup tracks, and it's starting to short in there. Okay, it's like a little short circuit building up all the way round, little pieces of carbon brush in there, and of course it's arcing across from one to the other to the other to the other. And of course, some little bits of dust are burning up, and that's what that really. I mean, it's an evil flipping bouquet that comes out of it, and something's not quite right with Big Dog. Now, I've had that battery light come on. Okay, I was going to take the case off, remove the case off camera, but I've had the battery light come on, so going to have to go for a change of batteries. And when we come back in the next section, don't move the muscle. It'll be straight after this. This casing will be off and we'll have a look around in there. I've got a whole pile of test leads there. And we will get this thing powered up with the casing off. And well, I'll be turning that dial, we'll have a kettle on it or something. And we'll see if we can get some sparks and pops in ways that I don't want it to be. Because, well, I've got a feeling, basically speaking, something's sparking and popping in there. And, well, I've got a feeling the contact surface of that brush, which sits on the pickup track, something's not quite right with it. Because the other night, like I was saying, I was using it, and there was a really sort of horrible bouquet coming out of it. That dial, I wouldn't say it got stuck in that position, but I could move it in one direction, but when you moved it back in the other room, it was a loud, I wouldn't say a loud clonk, but you could feel that there was something stuck there. And of course, moving it backwards and forwards a bit, I'll probably manage to free it up. But, yeah, something's not right in there. This casing's got to come off and we'll have a look around in there. Okay, so, go for change batteries. I'll just get those. Replacement batteries. Okay, so we're going to go for that. And, yeah, something's not right in there, people, and I'm disappointed. Okay, I can't even pull about 4 or 5 amps out of it without something, without it slinging up. I mean, I've pulled more than that out of my little 10-amp puppy, and that one hasn't complained. And then there's this one. It needs a bit of a service. Okay, so in for 5 minutes, I'm going to get on the next section now and have that casing off. Wallop. There it is then. Got the case off. And yeah, there's the pickup track on there. I've had a good look between the last section and this one, and I can't see any untoward damage to the pickup track, but even at this angle, if I get my screwdriver, it's around about there. Okay, you can see that something's gotten a bit hot there, and that there is around about the 140 volt mark as well. Okay, about there. And you can see on that, if I zoom on it, there you go, something's happened there. Okay, and a bit further along the line, that's happened there. Okay, about there, on the pickup track. So something's happened there, we had a bit of a pop there, and something's happened there, something's gotten a bit warm. Okay, yeah, I don't know what's going on there, but, well, watch this. There's my finger. See that? I think that needs a bit of a clean up. Okay, so I'm going to lower that camera down, give the wiping off, and, well, probably what I should do off camera is get a toothbrush and get in between each of them windings to make sure there's no brush build up in there, because something was sparking and popping in there a couple of nights back. And yeah, I'm not impressed really. That's all like I was saying. Well, I can you know, I've pulled about 3.8 kilowatts out of a little 10 amp puppy and it deals with it. That thing, you can't even take a flipping 2 kilowatt fan heater and it starts sparking and popping. I mean, something's not right, is it? You know, so, right, let's lower that camera down, no waffle, let's just get in there, because, well, time's getting on, it's about 5 to 11 at night. Okay, now the reason why I'm doing it that late at night, doing this examination so late at night, is because I won't be able to do it on camera, because it would be dark, but what I want to do is power that thing up in the dark. Okay, I've got a little flashy light. Okay, it's my little flashy light there. Okay, you can see that, there you go. Okay, a little flashy light. And what I want to do is I want to power that up in the dark, put the old satisfaction dial on there, turn it up, and see if there's any sparking on the on that pickup track. Okay, obviously speaking, those ventilation holes on the side of that case, they are not in line with that pickup track. They are slightly above it. Okay, because if they were sort of in line with it, and something accidentally got poked in there, it's obvious what's going to happen, especially at the upper end. Someone's going to get zapped, or if it's metallic, you know, if it makes contact with the case, it'll be in a way to quite bang. So, yeah, the actual ventilation holes in those, in that case, are slightly higher up than that pickup track. Okay, the pickup track is actually about there, inside the Variac, and you've got the ventilation holes up there. And it's a flipping good thing the ventilation holes are there, because, like I was saying the other night, something in there started getting a bit whistly, and, yeah, it was a really proper flipping rank smell coming out of it. It wasn't very nice. And, yeah, so, let's see if I can rub that off. If that rubs off, that'll be fantastic. There you go. Oh, I think I've spotted the problem. We got a dirty pickup track. And upon getting all that dirt and rubbish off, yeah, you can see that there's a that there, that does not look good. Something's gone, bit of a pop there. I think I rubbed it off. Again, off camera, that is disgusting. I've got a feeling that we'll need a replacement brush. Okay. Because admittedly, when I got this Variac, I did have the casing off and check the brush. And upon putting the brush back in, I couldn't get it to seat properly. Okay, and because of that, what I'd done in that brush holder, just around inside there, okay, I did put a little bit of Vaseline in there, and I'm wondering if this has gotten a bit warm, and the Vaseline's melted and run down and dripped all over the brush, and then it's caused that. Okay, so, but yeah, you can see that on there, these marks. Something's not quite right there, people. Okay, so old Big Dog is going to need a proper flipping clean up of that pickup track. We'll have that brush out of there and examine it, possibly on camera. Yeah, that there is not rubbing off. There's something happened there. Like I say, I was using this the other night, and I wouldn't say the dial got stuck, but it can turn in one direction, but not the other. So, yeah, something's not quite right there. So I've just given that a cleaning like that, with a bit of kitchen towel, nothing special. And we got that. And if I pick the camera right up, you can see a vast improvement there from that little bit I've cleaned up. In reference, see all that dirt and rubbish around there? Okay, it looks like a dirty, mucky old engine, doesn't it? So, yeah, I've got a feeling old Big Dog was just due in for a bit of a clean-up. Look how disgusting that pickup track is. And funnily enough, when I said the other night there was a bit of a spark and a pop come out of it, it was from around about that area as well. So it's probably just poor contact. I think something's gotten a bit hot in there and gone off a bit of a pop. Okay, fortunately, it hasn't damaged the pickup track. So, yeah, I might need to have all that brush holder assembly out of there and see what's happening with it. I am disappointed. Really, I am. Again, I've got bits of carbonated kitchen towel in between the windings. When rubbing, look, you can see it's chewing the kitchen towel up. When rubbing these, don't go left to right. Go from the outer edge, inner edge. Go from there outwards, okay? Because if you go from left to right, it'll chew the kitchen towel up, and then you get bits of kitchen towel stuck between the windings. And if it's got all that dirt and rubbish on it, it'd probably be conductive. And when you power it up, something's going to go off with a bit of a bang in there. And yeah, if it starts burning up, and with this stuff you get flames, you could imagine how much of a mess it'll make of your Variac. Okay. So, yeah, like I say, something's gone on there. Where is it? That. Okay, so I'm going to have a more in detail close up look at that. I don't know. It doesn't feel rough. I don't know. It does a little bit. But it's sort of on that inner edge. It's not there. Okay, let me see if I can zoom on that. I'm already pretty zoomed in on it anyway. The camera's going out now. Yeah, something's gone on in there, people. I'm not impressed. Yeah, look, I say that there. That mark on those three, was it two or three? Two. That there. It doesn't feel rough where the brush would make contact, but just down there, it does feel a little bit. On these, my finger just slides straight off. But there's a bit of a lip. And I've got a feeling something in there has gone a bit of a pop. Let's see if I can clean it up a bit more. Yeah, look, I've got a bit more dirt and rubbish out of it. So, but yeah, that pickup track is going to need a proper servicing. Right, where are we? Almost 10.5 minutes into this section. Right, I'll say well, we're slipping a little commercial break. When we come back, I shall have that pickup track completely cleaned up. Okay, so come back in a minute, straight after this. Okay then, so we're back, and what you're looking at there up in front of the camera is the brush holder with the brush contained in it. Okay, I can say that I've cleaned up the pickup track, and yeah, Big Dog really needed a proper clean up. That was the brush, a different type of brush, and that was all the dirt and rubbish in between the windings. Okay, there you go. So yeah, Big Dog really needed a very thorough cleaning up. That's probably why it started complaining, because well, Big Dog needed to visit the vet basically. Yeah, but almost an hour later after the last section. Okay, it's taken me a good hour to really bring the shine back up on that pickup track. Let's have a look at it. As you can see, it is so much better. Okay. Look at that, field of shine. There we go. Let me move that out of the way. Oh, just very careful with that. You don't want to damage that. But if I can move that out of the way, you can see right there, it's all nice and clean once again. Let me wind that camera up a bit. Right, there we go then. So you can see it's all nice and clean in there again. Without rosing out a bit as well, wouldn't it? There we go. So I've thoroughly cleaned that up. But that brush though, I've had a look at it, and it wasn't the greasy mess that I thought it was. Like I say, I've had the, you can see it there, it's not in the pickup arm anymore. It's right there. And, well, you can't see it there, but if I zoom right in on it, let me lower that camera back down. But the surface of that brush, which makes contact with that pickup track, it is relatively smooth. Okay, there's no big holes and chunks missing out of it and whatnot. So, let's see if I can get on it, but, you know, the cameras look for zoom. Is that it? You can see the surface there. There you go. That's a bit out, isn't it? There you go. So you can see that surface there on that brush. Relatively clean and smooth. I'm just trying to get it so it reflects the light from kitchen light. There you go. So you can see on there, it's relatively smooth. And that's what we want. I don't want big holes and chunks missing out of it. So we've got a good uniform contact on that when that's in the brush holder, when the brush is in the pickup arm. But what I will say on that is this spring, which pushes down, it doesn't actually press straight downwards, which would be a better design. So if there's anyone from Carol and Maynell watching, that spring on there needs to be redesigned. Okay, basically the way that's working at the minute, if I can get this camera wound back up, okay, the way that works in there, that spring, it sort of pushes, instead of it pushing straight down like that, it sort of pushes down at an angle like that sort of thing. Okay, and because of that, if I look at that top of that brush, okay, there's the brush holder. I don't know if you'll see it, but there's the top of the brush holder. And if you look at that top of that brush there, that surface, okay, that's not square at all. Okay. And although all of that surface makes contact with the pickup track, my point being is that's not wearing down in a uniform sort of way. Okay. Like I say, that spring there, it sits on top of that and pushes it up against the pickup track, but it doesn't sort of push down in a uniform sort of way. It sort of pushes down like that sort of thing. So all of the pressure is not right on that surface. Okay, it'll be right on this edge. Okay, and because of that, it's that brush is wearing down in such a way that that's not square on the top there anymore. Okay, I don't think that matters too much in regards to surface contact area on the pickup track, but you know it's better if you have an even wear on that. Okay, I will see if I can get the camera right next to that spring that I was saying about. You can see how it works from that, even from this angle. But yeah, there you go, you can see that. I'm just trying to lock the camera into place. Right, you can see how that works. That's a very strong spring on there as well. I've got to get a screwdriver under there to lift it up. But yeah, you can see how that works. You see? And even with that right down, you can see that gap there at this end. Okay, there's no gap at that end. Okay, so like I was saying, that spring, it doesn't push straight down. It sort of pushes at an angle like that. And because of that, it's wearing that brush down at a funny angle like that. Okay. So really speaking, if there's anyone from Carol and Maynard watching, that spring needs to be redesigned. Okay. I'm pretty sure inside that case, that one, there's plenty of space above that where you can incorporate some kind of coily spring which presses down on that in a uniform pressure. Okay, because, well, you can see it there. Okay, there's more pressure at this end of the brush than what there is at that end of the brush. And because of that, it's wearing that brush down and putting a funny angle on the top of it. Okay. Although when that's in there, all of that surface is in contact with the pickup track. More point being here is when that is in contact with the pickup track, there's going to be more pressure on that end of the brush than what there isn't going to be on that end of the brush. Okay? And because of that, it does make me wonder if because of that spring and a non-uniform spring pressure across the length of that brush, whether it's that causing the sparks and the pops. Okay. But yeah, that spring idea on that needs to be redesigned. Okay, it's not really at its best. Because, well, you can see it there. Okay, that gap. I've got a bit of paper here somewhere. Right, bit of paper. If I get that in there you go, you can see that. What I need is to tear a piece off. So big. Yeah, piece of paper. Get it in there. There you go, you can see that. I can get it in there, but as I move it along, I can't pull that out because the spring's in contact with the pickup arm. So yeah, you can see that gap there. There you go. So yeah, if that was pressing down in a uniform sort of fashion on that. Okay, if that was pressing down in a uniform fashion, I wouldn't be able to get that in there and move it along like that. But it stops about there because at that in there, right, just on that edge, that is where all the pressure is. Okay, now there's going to be a few people saying to me, oh yeah, it's like that because you haven't got the brush holder in there. Okay, so which is currently bent like that. Once you get the brush holder in there, it will be nice and flat and pressing down in a uniform fashion on that brush holder. Well, if it was, well, explain your way out of that then. Okay. That the top of that is sloped, okay, but even though it is sloped, it does make full contact with the pickup track. But like I was saying, because you've got more pressure at that end of the brush and not that end of the brush, you're not going to get even pressure on that pickup track. And because of that, you know, one end of that brush is not going to have too much, enough pressure than what that end is. And because of that, there may be small issues there. Okay, it's a bit coincidental that I was getting sparks and pops. Okay. So, let me get that brush back in the holder then. I'll do that on camera. There it is then. And that just slots in. Which way round does it go? Again, I want to get it back in there the proper way because, yeah, I think it's pretty obvious it goes that way. There we go. In it goes. Okay, it's in there now. Did you see that? There it is. Okay, so that's in there. And there we go. I will see if I can... I'm going to take the camera off the tripod, so it's going to get a bit shaky. Right, camera is off the tripod. If it gets a bit wobbly, you know how it is. Right, as you can see there then, there's the brush in there. And there's a spring sat on top of that brush holder. You see? And even at this angle, you can see that that spring on there, it's got more pressure at this end of it than what it is if that focus was to stay still. Probably because I've got hold of the camera. Right, that spring has got more contact, more pressure at this end than what it's got at that end. Okay. And, yeah, because of that, you're going to get more pressure on that brush at this edge than what you are at this edge, right at the back here. And another thing as well, I think that brush could do with being a bit wider. Okay, because you look how wide this pickup track is, and then look how wide that brush is. I think personally that brush could do with being a bit wider. Okay, and to make that wider, this pickup arm's going to have to be redesigned. Okay. So there we go. But it's repaired. I've cleaned it up and repaired it. So, yeah, what I've got to do next then is there's a little retainer plate somewhere. Just there. Okay, little retainer plate right there. And that goes on there. Okay, and it holds that brush holder in. Okay, so I've got to put that in. And, yeah, the reason why I was saying earlier on is I put loads of Vaseline or petroleum jelly or whatever you want to call it. Other brands are available, sort of thing. The reason why I put loads of it in there is because when I put that retainer plate on, it was pressing up against that brush holder. And I couldn't get it to seat properly. So I thought to myself, if I put a bit of something a bit slippery in there, it can move up and down as required. Okay. When I got that brush out, it wasn't the greasy mess I thought it would be. It was actually relatively clean and tidy. But then having said that, I've got a feeling the only reason why it's relatively clean and tidy is because during use, something's got a bit hot in that sort of region, and some of the, I don't know, it could have either melted in that gap, okay, between the brush holder and the pickup arm, and dripped out. Okay, I don't know how runny petroleum jelly could be when you heat it up. Okay, but see, so yeah, it could have melted sort of thing and dripped out, dripped on the pickup track, And of course, then the brush comes around, rubs it all in. You get a bit of a poor contact, and then you get your sparks and pops. Okay, so I've had all that out of there and cleaned it all up. And, well, I think by that toothbrush, that kind of explains how mucky and dirty it was. In between each of the windings, okay, I went on there like that all the way around. Just make sure there's no bits of kitchen towel or carbon brush in between each winding. And there we are. So, that takes us in for another 15 minutes about now. I don't know if you can see that. There we go. 12:15 at night. Okay. Next test I want to do, I'll do that off camera, is I want to get that little retainer plate put back on there. We're going to get this powered up. I'm going to do it off camera because there's exposed live parts on there and I don't really want to be waffling on and have that live, because just in case I accidentally touch it, I'll get a wallop. Okay, I'll need full-on concentration while doing the spark test. Okay, and basically what the spark test is, you energise it up, get a load on it. Put the old satisfaction dial back on the shaft and then you turn it. Okay, and of course, if that brush is not making proper contact with that pickup track, at certain points, as you turn it around, it will start sparking and popping. Okay, which basically means that the brush would need to be seated back in again. And that basically means what you do is have that end plate back off, you de-energise it at this point. Have that end plate back off, lift the brush up, you slot in there some very, very fine sandpaper, and you slide the sandpaper in and out, and back and forth, you move the pickup arm backwards and forwards, and the fine sandpaper sands down the surface of the brush and gets it to sit square on that pickup track. But like I say, I've had it out of there. The surface of it looks relatively sort of clean. There's no big chunks missing out of it or anything. And then put it back in there the way round it came out, because you've got this little wire on here. Okay. I can't remember who it was who said to me now that this wire does look a bit thin on here. Okay. Don't worry too much about that, because that brush is all obviously conductive. So is that big brass block, that's conductive. So is that spring, and this whole arm becomes live when it's energised up. And that bolt there is a wire attached to that. I don't know if I'll be able to get on it. There it is, you can see that wire in there, this white one. There it is, that white wire, you can see my finger on it. Okay, and that wire goes to the output terminal. Okay, once again, I do think, really speaking, that wire would be better connected up this end. I know you've got all of this surface contact area and cross-sectional area and all that lot. But, you know, does it really need to conduct the power all the way through that to that point? You know, I don't really think it's necessary. Okay, instead of having that connected right back there, why is this wire not really sort of super chunky and then just connected straight onto that and going to the output terminal on the terminal post? You know, these things have got to be asked. Why is that like that? Okay. I know my little tenant puppy hasn't even got that. Okay, there's like two metal plates in the middle that are in contact with each other. And then there's a metal strip which comes out of there. And, that there would actually be the output terminal. But on this one, they've actually put a wire on there. And that goes down to the output terminal instead. Okay. All right, in for 19 minutes then. I'm going to do the spark test off camera. And then I should be back after the break. Okay, then, next section. Quite late at night, actually. It's 1:10 in the morning now. I have done spark test on the on that, and I can quite successfully say that there's no sparking going on. I had it energised up, as you see up in front of the camera there. and I was turning this up and down. Okay, that dial on top is currently loose at the minute. Okay, so yeah, I did do a spark test. So yeah, all is okay there. But what I will say on that is this. That magnetic lump in there, this, I don't really think that is sat in there square. Okay, because when I turn that around, that brush, which is over there at the minute, if I turn it up to about there, okay, that brush sits reasonably square or right across that pickup. Okay, but if I turn it to about there, okay, there's a bit of a gap. Okay, I've got a shiny, where's my little light? It's here somewhere. But if I shine a beam of light underneath there, and if you get down on the floor and look underneath, you can actually see a bit of a gap. And I've got a feeling, basically speaking, this magnetic lump, it's not been seated in there squarely at all. And because of that, I've got a feeling this basically, as this comes around, this slopes down. Okay, so I might have to have this out. But that will be for another video for another day. Again, next this comes out. There's a whopping great bolt down there. And another one in there. And there's four of them. Okay, here comes Tobias. So, yeah, so I'm going to have to adjust those and try and bring this up a bit so that it's more seated in there more squarely. And but that's it for now. Managed to, there's a Tobias. So, yeah, that's it for now. But I did do a quick test on it and there's no sparks coming out of it. So all is well there. But yeah, in another video for another day, because it is 1:10 in the morning now, I want to try and get this lump out and try and raise this side up a bit. Okay, maybe consisting of packing it out with a bit of cardboard or something like that, or a couple of bits of folded up paper. But you can see these plastic grip rings here. There'll be another one under the underside of this. And it'll be just a case of raise this up by a few fractions of a millimetre. So that when that brush comes round, it is sat right across that pickup track, okay? Because at the minute, there's a bit of a gap. I tried reseating the brush, and yeah, I did that quite successfully. And from about there to about there, it sits nice and squarely on that pickup track. But from there down to the 270 volt range, and from there back down to zero, it starts getting a bit gappy basically. And I've got a feeling, basically speaking, this whole thing, it's at an angle like that, if you can imagine it like that. And that's a bit extreme when I say it, an angle like that, but it's only ever so slightly, this side here is slightly lower down than what this side here is. And because of that, that brush is just not sitting squarely right the way around that pickup track. Because of that, I have to be really, really honest and say that if I did try pulling 28 amps out of this thing, I think it would struggle a bit. Okay, because, well, that brush, it's not making full contact on that pickup track right the way across there, right the way around, if that makes any sense. But, yeah, I got a 3 kilowatt load gun on that, basically the kettle, put the kettle on it, and turned it right the way up and down again. No sparks and pops. But, yeah, afterwards, when I turned the power off, took the plug out, there's the plug, I did actually get hold of that spring. There's a bit of warmth there, and it was only on 3 kilowatt kettle. Okay, 3 kilowatts, that's about, well, I had it about there, and it was getting warm. Okay, so down there, 3 kilowatt, 240 volt load, about there would be pulling about 12 and a half amps off the wall socket, and consequently, 12 and a half amps off the brush. Okay, because it's 240 volts at that point. So therefore be 12.5 amps whacking through that brush. But if you wind it back there, because the voltage goes down, the amount of current goes down, and so does the amps. And that there was very mildly warm. And yeah, I think really speaking, that shouldn't get warm like that. Firstly at that point on the scale, and secondly only with it was probably pulling less than 3 kilowatts. Okay, if I'd done worked out the voltage and resistance of the kettle, that there was probably only around about 8 or 9 amps, and that thing was starting to warm up a bit. So at a later date in another video, I'm going to have to basically take this Variac to a particularly high level of precision, okay, loosen these big old fixing bolts out, probably have this entire lump out with this mounting base, and see if I can, just a few fractions of a millimetre, get this side of this raised up ever so slightly, because like I say, that thing in there, I don't think it's completely horizontal flat. Okay, if I turn it round a bit, because it's still on its wheels. Yeah, I've got a feeling basically that sort of this part from about there down, that sort of, that half of it, is it's tilted down like that. Because when you turn that brush up to there, it gets a bit gappy underneath there. That brush is not sitting right across that pickup track right the way around. And, yeah, I'm a little disappointed about that. If there's anyone from Carol and Maynard watching, then things like this need to be sorted out, okay? Because it clearly says on the specification plate, the solder's 28 amp Variacs. And basically speaking, I think this one as it currently is would struggle to take 28 amps, okay? Because, well, like I say, I don't think this lump is sat on that base squarely, horizontally. Okay, sort of it's a bit skew-whiff like that. I know it's a bit of an extreme angle when I say that, like that. But, you know, it's this side here compared with there. That there, what I'm tapping with my finger, that is, you know, a few fractions of a millimetre lower than what that is, okay? These things need to be set in there to, you know, a high degree of precision. And another thing I want to recap on as well is that spring. Okay, not really too impressed with that. Okay, that needs to be pressing down on that vertically. Okay, not at an angle like that. Okay, because like I say, there's more pressure at that edge there than what there is back there. Okay, and because of that, not only is it putting uneven pressure on that pickup track, but it's also wearing the brush down unevenly as well. Okay. So I'm going to get off now for 9 minutes on this section, get the case back on, and get off the bed. Okay, so 1:16 in the morning, people. Thanks for watching.